Welcome to my channel. My name is Alisa, and today what I want to bring you guys is my natural hair journey slash my transition story. So stay tuned and watch how I went from this to that. Now first off, I want to start off by saying I have been natural all my life, but I got my hair straightened habitually, maybe every once a month, every couple of weeks. And my hair was really stressed and it was really damaged from heat. And like, I tried to go natural, my styles wouldn't come out right, you know, I had the little scraggly ends, and it was almost like I was transitioning in a sense. And I feel like some people can get their hair straightened often and they don't have as much heat damage, but I really figured out myself and my hair. I have high porosity hair and I can't do what everybody else does and expect to keep my curls intact. So I just have to really be cautious and careful. And that leads me to the very first thing that I stopped doing in order to get my hair back healthy and my curls full of life. And that is, I stopped straightening. It's so important because I've had so many setbacks when it comes to heat. Like, I got my hair done a couple times and it completely made me have to start over from the beginning. Like, I remember I got my hair straightened one time and the whole back of my head was straight. And I was just so discouraged. I was like, I did all of this growing and all of this, you know, work and maintenance on my hair just for it to be ruined for a style that's only gonna last me 2 weeks. So yeah, that straightening stuff had to go. Number two is I cut off the damaged ends. Like, once I struggled with the heat damage and stuff and, you know, all that breakage and just the nasty ends, I started cutting it off gradually. I didn't want to do the big chop. And I mean, some people, that works for some people, I personally didn't want to do it. So I just, you know, I transitioned and cut off the ends slowly. And that's when I slowly started to see my curls come in and they were way more juicier, full of life. And honestly, I used to think my hair was wavy, but it's really not. I have pretty tight curls and the heat was like preventing me from like reaching my full potential, should I say. Number three, I stopped manipulating my hair a lot. And when I had heat damage, I used to have to do my hair more frequently. I noticed my styles wouldn't last as long. So every night I was twisting my hair, I was putting it in bantu knots, doing twist outs. And I just noticed like my hair slowly breaking off. I would go to the salon and they would ask me like, what happened to your hair? And like, my hair just couldn't handle it. It was weak because it was already heat damaged. And you know, heat damaged strands, if you compare them, like your natural strand that is not manipulated and not that is healthy is gonna come out better in styles, you know, because that strand is more juicier. Number four, I started moisturizing my hair on a frequently basis. And honestly, I started knowing how to actually moisturize until recently, a year maybe. Like, I started doing the lock method and it's really, I've been noticing more length retention and my hair is just more like bouncy, full of life. And you can tell when your hair is moisturized. Well, I can tell when my hair is moisturized. Your hair thrives on water. And that people don't understand that. They think you could just put an oil on your hair and that will keep it moisturized. But you have to spray your hair with water. You have to, you know, keep your hair, like, these products are gonna help your hair and prevent them from getting dry. So that's why it's important to put like layers of things. And especially if you're high porosity. I know I have fine high porosity hair and my hair gets dry really, really quick. So I've really had, I have to like build a barrier on my hair strands to prevent them from getting dry as often. And number five, I would say I stopped listening to what people had to say. You have to do what is best for you and forget all those haters, all those negative comments and stuff. And when I first went natural, I didn't have much support at all. People would ask me, when are you gonna get your hair done? They would tell me I like your hair better straight. I didn't waver and I did what was best for me. I figured out my hair and how it works, because not everybody's hair does the same thing. You gotta be realistic. I like that big fluffy hair, but I don't have 4C hair. I don't have like really kinky hair. And you know, I feel like we just have to know, find out what works best for us, what makes our hair the most healthy. And to not just focus on other people's hair journey and compare it to yours, because everybody is going to have a different hair journey. So don't get discouraged. Like, hair grows and you should have fun in the process of doing it. Thank you guys so much for tuning into my first video. I'm so excited to be bringing you guys flexi rods, bantu knots, twist styles, and even I'm going to incorporate some protective styles. So come and join this natural hair journey with me. And also, don't forget to subscribe.